The federal government is standing firm tonight in rejecting a chorus of calls to expand the JobKeeper program in the wake of a $60 billion accounting bungle. Many who've missed out on help are pleading their case, but the Treasurer says they're asking for money that he doesn't have.
From the bright lights of the stage,
my hands are cold, but my feet are not,
to lounge room isolation, Alex Leahy's music lives on, but she's crying out for government support for an industry demolished by a shutdown that has no release date.
And given that we don't know when that is right now, it's really important to make sure that the industry is supported until then.
Labor believes it has an answer after
the biggest error made in any budget by any government at any point in the history of this country.
A tax office revision of the JobKeeper wage subsidy has halved the number of people on the program, slashing its expected cost from $130 to $70 billion.
I take responsibility for this and am accountable through the Parliament.
Labor's demanding the scheme be broadened to include the tens of thousands who missed out, like those in the music industry.
This is a good program, but that too many people have been excluded from it, and that means the unemployment queues will be longer.
The government says it won't spend cash it doesn't have.
We don't have to go and borrow that money, and that's the key point. For future generations, there'll be less borrowings to pay back.
Labor wants this fight to be about the government's competence as economic managers.
The days of this government being taken seriously on the budget or the economy are long gone.
Resetting economic growth is the theme of a speech the Prime Minister will deliver tomorrow, as he lays out the guiding principles for the reform of skills, vocational education and industrial relations. Chris Yuleman, Nine News.